In this video, I'm going to be showing you the best camera bag for travel and landscape photography coming up. Hey, what's up guys? Dave here, and on this channel I help you improve your photography through in-field and post-processing tutorials as well as gear reviews like this one. And in this video I'm going to be reviewing the best camera bag that I've ever found for travel and landscape photography, and that is the F-stop Gear Tilopa 50 liter camera bag. You can see it right here. I have it in this beautiful bright orange color. And the first thing that I always look for in a camera bag is versatility. And this bag is one of the most versatile bags that I've ever found. It does have really good sturdy straps for your tripod on either side. If you wanted it on this side, you could throw it over here and put it in these straps. Even if you wanted it on the front, you could strap it in here on these front straps that are really sturdy. You could just cinch these up and have your tripod really tight. I love this because typically I like my tripod on this side whenever I am going out to shoot. However, I typically do shoot photos and videos while I'm out in the field, so having another strap on this side that allows me to put another tripod in on either side really helps me out whenever I am going out to shoot. And even having the ability to put one on front is useful too. Not only that, but it has tons of compartments that you can use for storing a lot of extra gear. You have this top compartment that you can put just like any extra gear, extra batteries, you know, extra SD cards, gloves, anything like that that you can have up top. And then it has another separate spot up top for you to put more extra gear that actually sits down on top of the camera gear that's in your bag. So you have this section up here that allows you to put like jackets. You know, I have a couple more extra filters that are up top that just sits on top of your internal compartment unit that's inside for your bag here that I'll get to in just a second. And also on all these, you have these really good sturdy mesh pockets that you can put extra gear. Again, you can fit down some batteries in here, some more SD cards, things like that, for you to just store other things in your camera bag. It does also have a pocket up front if you want to store a rain jacket. I have the rain fly for this bag in here in this compartment that's right here. And then also different sections underneath your tripod storage. You do have pouches down here on the side that allow you to put like extra snacks or anything that you just want to store in here. Really good for water bottles. That's what I use these for. So just a really good versatile bag. Now, even getting into the back section, we can look at some of the camera gear that I have in here. And it's just more versatility going on in this part of the bag. So inside you'll see this internal compartment unit that you can use to store and organize all of your camera gear. These adjust and move around with Velcro. And I don't like the ones that are just so flimsy that just fall off and fall over and the Velcro wears down. I like these because they're really sturdy. They keep all your camera gear in place, but you can easily adjust these. Like I have two camera bodies in here, a 70-200, a wide angle lens connected to one of my bodies, and just tons of accessories that are stored all around here. You can also access some of the top compartment gear up through the top of this back and rear access point of this bag. I also like that they do have another zipper up here that's in the front that you can store a few more SD cards if you want those in. And this is a really hard, sturdy back to this bag. If you are hiking and it's bumping against your back, it doesn't damage your camera gear, so I like that too. Another thing that I love about my bags is having a comfortable bag. So if I'm out in the field hiking miles to get to a location and get to a certain shot and get filming on a certain area, I have to have a comfortable bag. This one does it. Number one, the framing is aluminum, really lightweight, and keeps your bag extremely sturdy. That's how it sits up on its own right now, and I've even placed this down on several rocks that are uneven and things like that, and it still sits up on its own, so I really enjoy that. Nothing smashes this bag or anything. This is a really good framing system. Also, the padding on the straps that go over your shoulders is extremely comfortable too, very easy to adjust, and you even have these little pockets that help you put your extra length of your straps down in here and keeps those stored away way for you whenever you are out in the field. The hip straps too are extremely comfortable. Like, I've had bags that have hip straps that are just like barely nylon covering your hips. These are extremely padded and work really well whenever you are out in the field. Really, really comfortable and easy to adjust whenever you are out into the field. One thing I do wish that they did have was a pocket on some of the hip pads to allow you to access like a radio, a cell phone, an extra snack here and there if you are hiking long distances. But they are extremely good padded straps. Next up is the durability of this bag is second to none. Like, I've had this bag in some of the worst locations, freezing weather, heat, rain, snow. This bag holds up extremely well. It's this material that's on the front of this bag that just does a really good job of keeping out any moisture and keeping your bag and gear protected against those really hard surfaces that you do have. Also, all of the zippers have this really good lining that allow you to keep all of the rain out that's coming in, all the moisture, the snow. Just anytime you are unzipping or zipping your bag up, they don't get caught, they don't get tangled. It's just a really good way of you to continue keeping moisture on the outside of your bag. This bag does also have different things like these areas on the bag that are just a little more sturdy. On the bottom, it has a good area that when you set it down, you know moisture is not going to get in. It's just an extra layer of material to keep water on the outside, your camera gear dry inside. This bag does also have a rain fly. One of the downsides of this bag is that the rain fly is not included. So I did purchase this rain fly separately, but it's a really good rain fly, but I do think it's a downside that it is not included. Just because if you are spending this amount of money on a bag, why not just throw in the rain fly for free? That doesn't make much sense to me, but I do have it stored down here on this front zipper pouch. Inside this bag, you can also fit a pretty big laptop. I have a 13-inch laptop on the inside. You can also fit a 15-inch laptop inside of the bag. A little bit more of a drawback here to have it on the inside versus a sleeve on the outside that you can put it in, because going through security lines in the airport, you do have to reach all the way into your bag to get that laptop out. It is more protected being inside, but it is more of a hassle going through security to have to do that. As a next step, you can click on the playlist that's showing up on your screen right now. That's going to take you to several videos on all of the gear that I have stored inside of this bag and reviews on those for you to make decisions on what to purchase for your landscape photography.